Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn about the types of the doors, the windows, and the types of the windows. So there are 7 types of the doors which we are going to see. That is the panel door, batten door, flush door, collapsible door, rolling shutters, revolving doors, and glazed doors. So the paneled or a framed door. So these doors consist of a frame made up of stiles, a top rail, sometimes a intermediate rail. Into this framework, a plywood panel is fitted. This panel may fit into the groove or a rivet. So the panel door is a simple door in which we are having a bottom rail and the top rail. In this image, you can see here it is a bottom rail, here it is a top rail, and the side slides, and to these frame or to these rails one plywood panel it is attached at the center. So as per the design of the door, we may have a 2-paneled or 3-paneled door. So the panel door, it is generally made up of the timber. So these are the some types of the panel doors, that is the 1-panel, 2-panel, So the shapes of the panels, that is depending on the design of the door. 3-panel or the 3-panel, 5-panel, 6-panel. So these types of some panel doors which we are going to use into the building construction. The second type of the door, that is the battened and ledged doors. So in this type of the door, what we are doing, the vertical battens are taken. So in this image you can see here the vertical battens, these are attached with the help of this ledge, and this ledges supports these vertical battens or attach these vertical battens to each other, and according to that the door is constructed. So these doors consist of vertical boards called the battens, which are nailed or screwed to the horizontal members called ledges. Often the battens are about 15 to 18 cm wide and 2 to 3 cm thick. The door made with narrow battens like these have a better appearance. With the braces, this is a ledged and battened door to which the braces have been added to prevent the sagging. The braces must slope upwards from the hinge edge of the door, and they are housed with the skew notch into the ledges. So sometimes to these battened doors we are going to provide the braces which are in the inclined order, and which binds the these vertical boards with proper manner. So these are the battened or the ledged doors. Next type of the door, that is the flush doors. So the flush door is a framed cover. It is a type of the door that we frequently make in rural buildings. This door consists of a frame which has a slides, top and bottom rails, and narrow intermediate rails. It is covered on the each side by a sheet of plywood. Plywood covered flush doors cannot be used where they will be exposed to the rain or the sun. So the flush doors are the simple framed doors which are generally used into the residential buildings. So this is the one piece of wooden plywood which is attached to the door frame. So these types of doors, these are generally not used where the doors are exposed to the rain and the sun, because these may be damaged by the rain water and by sun shade due to effect of the heat on the wood. Next type of door, that is the collapsible door. Such doors are used into the garages, workshops, public buildings, etc. to provide increased safety and protection to the property. The doors do not require hinges to close or open the shutter nor the frame to hinge them. It acts like a steel curtain. The door is made up from vertical double channel jointed together with the hollow on the inside to create a vertical gap. These channels are spaced at 100 to 120 mm apart and based with the diagonal iron flats. These diagonals allow the shutter to open or close. The shutter operates between two rails, one fixed to the floor, other is fixed to the lintel. The rollers are mounted at the top and the bottom. So in this figure you can see the collapsible door, generally which we are going to use into the garages, workshop and the public building for the safety purpose and for the protection of the property. These doors are not having any type of frame or any type of shutter. These are generally made up of channels which are connected to each other, and these are fixed on the base with the help of rollers and at the top with the help of rollers. So these can be rolled over it and these can be used. So this is the next type of the door. Next, that is the rolling shutters. These are commonly used for the shops, godowns, stores, etc. The door shutter acts like a curtain and thus provides a adequate protection and safety against the fire and the thieves. A shutter is made up of the thin steel slabs called a lath or slates, about 1.25 mm thick, interlocked to each other and coined upon specially designed pipe shaft called a drum mounted at the top. The shutter moves in two vertical steel guides channels installed at their ends. The channel is made up of steel sheets and deep enough to accommodate the shutter and to keep it in the position. The horizontal shaft and the springs in the drum which allow the shutter to coil or in out. These may be manually operated for smaller openings about 10 square meters. They may be operated manually. So these are the rolling shutters which are generally used into the shops or the godowns or the stores. These shutters are act like a steel curtains which provide the adequate protection and safety from the different fire and thieves. The shutter that is made up of the steel slabs called as lath and the slits, about 1.25 mm thick, interlocked to each other. These are generally fixed into the wall with the help of steel channel and guides, and that is installed at the wall with the required height. Generally the 10 square meter shutters, these are operated manually, and above that these have to be operated mechanically. Next, that is the revolving doors. Such types are provided in the building like banks, museums, hotels and offices, where the customers going in and out of the doors, they number of the customers that is more, and we have to operate the door at lot of the time in a day. So at that time we are providing the revolving doors. A revolving door normally has four wings or the leaves that hangs on the center shaft and rotate on one way about a vertical axis within the round enclosure. The central shaft is fitted with the ball bearing arrangement at the bottom, which allows the shutters to move without any jerk and the making noise. The radiating shutters may be fully paneled, fully glazed or partly glazed. The glass doors allow people to see and anticipate each other while walking through. The vertical rubber pieces are provided at the rubbing end of the shutter to prevent a draught of the air. The people can work out of and into the building at the same time. The door closes automatically when not into the use. So in this figure you can see the revolving doors. So this door, it is hinged at the center with the help of hinges. The rubber patches are provided at the top, side and bottom to avoid the entry of air. The glasses, these allow the persons to see in and out going on, and this revolves about around these hinges. Then the next, that is the glazed or the sash doors. So these are provided where the visibility of the interior of the room is required. So where the interior of the room that has to be visible at that places, the glazed doors are provided. The suitability of the types of the doors. Now we have seen the seven types of doors. Now that seven types of door, where that door can be fixed into the building. So for the main entrance of the residential bungalow, we have to use a fully paneled wooden door. For the bathroom and WC, we have to use a flush door. For the shop, rolling shutters we have to use. Then for computer laboratory, fully glazed door we have to use. Then for the entrance of the bank, we have to use a collapsible door. Then next, that is for in the garages, we have to use the rolling steel shutters. For the main door of residential building, we have to use the paneled door. And for the garden, we have to use a revolving door. So these are the suitability or where to use what type of the door that is given into this slide. Excuse me. Then next, that is the windows. The definition of windows: a window is defined as a vented barrier secured into the wall opening to serve one or the more of the functions like natural light, natural ventilation, and the vision. So the windows are generally provided into the wall openings to serve the purposes like ventilation, natural light entrance into the building, and the vision from inside to the outside. So these are the functions of the window: to admit the natural light into the building, to admit the air into the building, to give a view to the outside. And the windows must also provide for the insulation against the heat loss, and in some cases against the sound also. Some windows are also required to give a measure of resistance to the fire. So these are the functions of the window. Now, where to locate the window? The location and the number of windows should be decided on the basis of desired daylight and its distribution in the rooms, natural ventilation desired, vision of the outside, privacy of the occupants, and the heat loss, etc. So these are the some points on which we have to fix the location of the window. The main point or the main purpose for the location deciding, those are the first, the distribution of room, natural ventilation and light, the desired vision of outside, and the privacy of the occupants. So these are the main things on which we have to locate the window into the building. From the viewpoint of the ventilation, a window should be located in opposite wall facing a door or another window. So whenever we are fixing the window into the wall, then we have to fix it alternately or opposite to the wall facings. From the point of view of fresh air and maximum daylight, window should be located on the northern side of the room. The sill of the window should be located 0.75 to 1 meter above the floor level of the room. So according to that, the window can be placed into the wall. So these are the components of the windows. A lot of components are there. So head jump, top rail, bottom rail is there. Then stool is there, apron is there, exterior sill is there, channel in which window is fixed, then lower sash panel, then window panel, then slit, the vertical member of the window. Then here it is the side jamb in which we are going to fix the window. Then upper sash is there. Then sash lock is there, which locks the window panels. And head is there. So these are the some points or the some components of the windows, from which the top jamb is important, then side jamb is important, then style, which is the vertical member, and the panel of the window. So these are the components. Now the next part, that is the recommended dimensions of the windows. For the recommended dimensions of the windows, generally 600 by 1200, that is the size of the opening. For that, the frame size is given, and also for the window shutter size is given. So window opening with single shutter, WS, that means the window opening with single shutter, and window opening with double shutters. So according to that, the sizes of the windows in the residential as well as into the public building, that is mentioned into this slide. Now the types of the windows. So there are 14 types of windows which are provided into the buildings for the different purposes. Paneled window, fixed window, casement window, metal window, sliding window, lowered window, bay window, window grill, ventilators, corner window, gable window, dormer window, skylight and clear story window. So first we will see the casement window. The casement window is a window that is attached to its frame by one or more hinges. These are hinged at the side. They are used singly or in the pairs within a common frame, in which case they are hinged on the outside. So this is the image of casement window. We are generally having one window frame. To this window frame, with the help of hinges, the door is fixed. Generally this can be a single paneled or this can be a double paneled window. So this is the casement window provided into the building. Next, that is the fixed window. The fixed window, these are the windows designed that do not include any sashes or the sections of the window that are configured to open and close. So the fixed windows are those windows generally which are provided for the purpose of light only, for getting a light from outside to the inside. And these fixed windows, these cannot be opened or closed at any side. These are the fixed windows. These cannot be opened or closed. So the fixed windows are generally used for the purpose of lighting into the building. The opening is not there into the window. That is known as a fixed window. Now the next, that is the sliding window. The sliding window, these are the windows constructed in a frame and installed so that they slide open and closed as opposed to the opening into in or out on the hinges. So these are the buildings, these are the windows which are provided into the building where the inside and outside openings cannot be provided into the building. At that place, we are going to provide a sliding window. So these are the windows which are fixed into the frame and installed that they can slide upon and closed. म्हणजे स्लायडिंग विंडो, ह्या विंडो अशा असतात की त्या आपण जनरली डोर फ्रेम विंडो फ्रेमवरती फिक्स करतो आणि त्याच्यामध्ये आपण मग त्याचे जे काही पॅनल्स आहेत ते स्लाइड करून ओपन किंवा क्लोज करू शकतो. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दॅट द स्लायडिंग विंडोज आर प्रोव्हाइडेड इन टू द बिल्डिंग. नाउ द नेक्स्ट, दॅट इज द लोवर्ड विंडोज. सो दीज आर द विंडोज मेड ऑफ ग्लास स्लिट्स set in the metal clips that can be opened and closed in the unions. So these types of windows, these are generally provided into the WC and bathroom, in which the glass slits are there. Glass slits, these are fixed into the small channels and these are opened and closed with the unions. So these are the lowered windows which are going to provide into the building. Now the next, that is the bay windows. These are specially designed windows which create a niche into the home filled with light. Typically they highlight a stunning view such as the ocean or a sweeping meadow. And they are often designed with window seats so that the people can sit into the windows and enjoy a look. So the bay windows are the types of windows. So in this image you can see the shape of the window. These shapes are made like a lot of light and ventilation it is coming in and out of the structure. And these bay windows, these are provided with the seating arrangement also to sit and to have a natural view from the outside. So generally these types of windows are provided where seashores are there or any other gardening is there outside the room. At that time, to have a look of that view, we are going to provide the bay windows into the building. Now the next, that is the bay windows. It is a variation of the bay window. This window is so named because it has a slightly curved shape instead of the more angle shape of the bay window, and it looks like a curve of a drawn bow. So this is the bay window and bow window. These are the same types of windows which are provided for the same purposes also. Only the difference is that the shape of the window. In the bay window we are having a lot of angles, and in this type of window we are just having one curved portion. And the purpose of the two windows, that is the same, to have a lot of light and ventilation and as well to have a natural view of the outside. The next, that is the garden window. It is a window that just out and projects slightly from the wall in order to capture a more sunlight. Some may have a sleeves, and glass must be present on the all sides except for the bottom. So the garden windows are those windows in which we can have gardening also. So these are the windows which are projected outside the wall, and the all sides of the walls or all sides of the windows, that is covered with the glass. Only the bottom is fixed with the concrete or the tiles. So it will give a ventilation and light to the plants which we are going to put it over here. So in this image you can get a clear idea about the garden window. So ही garden window आहे, याच्या मध्ये आपण इथे जे काही आपले plants आहेत ते ठेवलेत, आणि याचे जे sides आणि bottom slides आणि tops आहेत, प्रत्येक ठिकाणी आपण glass provide केले so that natural light त्याला available होईल. So these are the garden windows. The next, in an arch and radius window, the bottom half of the window is rectangular while the top is an arch or the half circle. The arch shaped windows bring a softness to the room and juxtaposes the straight corners of the rectangular windows and walls for a contrasting effect. Arch windows can be openable to let it fresh air or fixed to only let into the light. So the shape of the arch windows, that is the bottom is rectangular but the top is having a arch shape. The next type of window, that is the skylight window. This window, it is installed on the ceilings of the home, bringing in the light and the views of the sky. The skylights are a great way to brighten up a space while ensuring a privacy, such as bathrooms. They also are a great addition to the rooms without outside facing walls. So in this image, at the top of the ceilings you can see here a skylight. So the skylight, the purpose of skylight is to provide natural light and brightness into the room. These are generally provided by considering the privacy of the occupants into the rooms. So the skylight windows are generally provided at the ceilings to have and skylight entering into the home. Next, that is the metal windows. So the metal windows made up of mild steel having lesser cost and more strength. So up till now, whatever we have seen, the types of windows, those are all are maybe of timber or maybe of the glass. So metal windows, these are all made up of the metal or the mild steel, which costs a lesser compared to the glass window. Then next, that is the dormer window. The dormer window is a window provided on the sloping roofs as shown in the figure. So on the sloping roof, for the ventilation or for lighting purpose, we are providing these types of windows, which are known as a dormer window. This will allow the entry of fresh air and light into the structure. Then the gable windows. It is a vertical window provided at the gable end of pitched roof. म्हणजे ज्यावेळी आपलं रूफ पिचड रूफ असतं त्यावेळी इथं जो हा ट्रँग्युलर पोर्शन तयार होतो तर या ट्रँग्युलर पोर्शनमध्ये जी विंडो आपण फिक्स करतो दॅट इज नोन ॲज अ गॅबल विंडो विच अलाउज द एंट्री अँड एक्झिट ऑफ लाईट इन टू द स्ट्रक्चर. देन द व्हेंटिलेटर्स. द व्हेंटिलेटर्स आर द स्मॉल विंडोज फिक्स्ड ॲट द ग्रेटर हाईट दॅन द विंडो, जनरली अबाउट 30 to 50 cm बिलो द रूफ लेवल. सो रूफ लेवलपेक्षा थोडं खाली म्हणजे 30 to 50 cm लेवलपर्यंत आपण व्हेंटिलेटर्स बसवतो. व्हेंटिलेटर्सचं मेन पर्पज असतं टू अलाउ द फ्रेश एअर इन द अलाउ द एंट्री ऑफ फ्रेश एअर इन अँड आउट ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर. सो द व्हेंटिलेटर्स आर प्रोव्हाइडेड नियर टू द ग्रेटर हाईट provided at the greater height, generally about 30 to 15 cm below the roof level. The ventilators are provided. The ventilators are not having any open and close mechanism. These are the openings which are provided into the building. So, today we have seen the types of the doors, the window, definition of window, and the types of the windows. Okay, so we will stop over here. Thank you.